As you can tell from the horrible destruction of the Yo-Yo and Trinket store, shopkeeper Tom, owner of this so-called store, is rather annoyed from what has happened from this horrible, horrible act of violence last night. He believes that an extinct species may be to blame here.
That's right, I've been the victim of a terrible crime. You know, I was just minding my own business at home, and then I came down this morning, and all my trinkets and all my yo-yos were gone. It's $100,000 worth of damage. It just tore right through the roof, like it tore through my heart. My family business and my granddad passed down onto me. For generations, it's just disturbing. And it leaves this tag. Who leaves tags? You know what? This is just kabonkers. This is disgusting. And the worst part was, I got indigestion from its moa eggs. It left lying all around the place. They were everywhere. And they gave me indigestion. What? What's that? Yeah, I'm not allowed to eat moa eggs. They're an endangered species. Oh. You guys can cut that out. Right?
Back on track with the story. Here we have Witness Brody, who was there when the brutal attack on the shop happened, and he saw what he thought to be a mower had run away. Let's go get his opinion on what really happened.
Well, the truth was, last night, I was just walking around, and I was just walking around town trying to hang out with my mates, Big Joey, and Little Joey, and medium-sized Joey, and Trevor. And we were just walking around, and then we heard this from there. And that was my dog, but my dog was barking. He was barking at the shop. And we just saw this big, massive creature. It was a mower.
After compiling all this evidence, we're gonna have to get someone to hunt this mower down. Let's go meet our heroes.
Calvin, you useless fool! Get out! Get out! Now, Calvin! Guthrie, hurry up! Guthrie, speed it up! Hurry up, Guthrie!
Big Knife, where are ya?
Calvin! We're coughing up leads! Guthrie! I'm over here! Hurry up! Calvin! There's the beast! Hurry up, you two!
Now, where am I?
Guthrie, big Knife! I can't find your useless brother anywhere! The beast is around here! Come on!
You're always stitching me.
Big Nine found him! And he's got the beast! Really? He's finally done something useful for once! Guthrie! Hold the beast down!
They look good at their job. Let's go talk to them, shall we? Here we go.
Morning!
Righto, yeah, we're the trio of three. We're the best hunters in all the land. There's me, Big Nige, down the daddy. That's old Guthrie, he's my oldest son. And Calvin's off somewhere, doing something useless. Yeah, he's no good. Yeah, so today's assignment was to get the beast of Fakatane. We managed to get him in the end. It was a bit of a beast to get. But yeah, and apparently now we're onto this new big mission about some endangered species. And it's been causing a right ruckus around the area in Papamoetoe. It's So yeah, we'll hit up that one, eh?
Yeah, I'm Guthrie, hardest worker of the two brothers. As you can see, hooking the base to the bonnet. Do you like it? Do you like it? I don't know where Calvin is. He's going off fiddlywink somewhere. Oh, hold up. What was that? Was that John? John Key, Prime Minister of New Zealand? Moa, Moa and Papa Matawi. Be right on to it, mate. Just on the Bluetooth headset.
Yeah, my name's Calvin. Today was a big day for me. Today was the day I could have proved myself as a good hunter, but I didn't. You know, I got stabbed in the wrist by Big Nige, my dad. It went straight through, pierced through there and out there. And then he decided to stitch it up with dental floss. It doesn't hold quite well. So tonight I might get a bit of gangrene. Guthrie, he's a terrible hunter. No offence to the man, he's quite good, but he decided that strapping the body of the beast to the bonnet was just placing it in an articulate style to suit the aesthetics. Not very smart at all, really, if you ask me. It's going to come off as soon as we drive, and I'll get the blame for it, because Dad and I have it in for me. So, after every hunt, I sort of have to come and meditate to myself.
What a loser. Anyway, time for day two. Clue searching.
Found a clue!
Well, as you can see here, it's the mower's footprint. Well, today has been a good day of the mower hunt, because for one thing, when I went to go for my morning shave at the hairdresser's, I got me a mullet extension. The kids love it. And even better, Guthrie found a clue to the mower for the mower hunt. He found a footprint. This shows that the mower is still around here somewhere. We just got to find it.
Big Nige, your mullet.
Cheap extensions.
Yeah, Big Nige, he's not in here.
Here it is, day three. Hunt for the mower.
Hey there, we got our specialist mower hunting equipment down there. Okay, just gonna give you a look at the inside of the life of the mower hunters. Night vision goggles. We got two sets of night vision goggles. Yep. Binoculi, these zoom in and out. Whenever you look into them, yes, very handy. We've got our stun guns. These shoot electrical waves that will stun the mower. They're quite handy.
How's it looking up there, Big Nige?
Mower, 7 o'clock.
Big Nige, spotted the mower at 8:30.
I said 7 o'clock!
So everything seems to be going good. It's on the old Bluetooth headset, talking to old Johnny boy, letting him know what's happening. Calvin's going to make me a cuppa. Seems to be a good day. Time for morning smoko.
I'm going on a mower hunt and I'm not scared. Going on a mower hunt and...
Where's my cuppa?
Now Guthrie! Is that you? Get out of the tree! Stop playing cameraman! We're trying to track the mower!
Oh, what is this?
Okay, so in the beginning, we thought we were looking for a mower. That's what we got told. But really, the people got their facts wrong, and what we were really looking for was a goat. Go, Calvin!
Yeah, well, today's the day I proved myself a hunter to Dad. I caught the mower of Papa Matawi. Yeah, funny story was, the New Zealand government got this goat here mixed up with the mower. You see, it's got this hat took from the trinket store. It's got some
glasses. These are custom made. The dude makes these himself. And it's got our yo-yos all up in its pockets.
Yeah, John. What's up with all these gates? They're all over Facebook.
So all in all, that was a good hunt. So it's a bit of annoying that we didn't find that extinct mower, but we're pretty happy with this goat here. Next time, John, get your facts right. We'll be coming for you, because this is just dangerous stuff, and we're looking for a mower, and we're just getting goats. But we're happy with this, anyway. Till the next mission, we're going to be eating good tonight.
What up, guys? It's me, Big Nice. How's it going? And this is Guthrie, all up on the interweb. Check it out, the song that... a few bleeps. But cut it out a little bit. Calvin can't be here, but we got old Johnny boy here. Oh, you're a crack up there, Johnny. Johnny boy, you like a curry goat? That's good. Oh yeah? Where was it filmed on location? Oh, those places. Those places are horrible. My style is UFO. Totally unknown. Can't with my new Zep flow. I'm hard to miss. You can't do this, you can't do that. Who said so? That's my son. That's his jam. How'd you think of that, John Key? Hey narrator, where you at?
I'm right here, been here the entire time. So, this is the end of the film. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and have a good life. We didn't find a mower, it's the worst thing of everything. No. Yep.
Goodbye from Big Nige and the others and all the hunters.
Do you like it? Do you like it? End.